Welcome to the MLS Show, Baz and Ped, back again in the armchairs. I've just decided we're going to call this Club Focus. We've done Dallas, we've done Seattle.
Club Focus,
sounds
come
good.
On.
Like football focus, soccer focus. This week, Ped, it's turn of the Timbers.
What a kit. I know it's not a brand new one, but it is absolutely just amazing.
The boss kit.
It is amazing kit. I love this kit.
Yeah, the scarf.
I think I'll take that to Portland with me when I go.
Bounce it on. Yeah. MLS Cup holders, of course. From last season. This time out, not as good. Just got some quick stats. MLS team since 2011. Who was the first manager?
The first manager of Portland Timbers would be John Spencer.
Oh, mate. And he didn't even see it. Class. He only lasted the year. But Caleb Porter has been a manager since 2013. Yep. Obviously, MLS Cup winners last year with a 2-1 win over Columbus Crew.
Mm.
This year, it's been a little bit up and down for them. Defensively, it's been a problem for them so far this year.
Yeah, Ridgie hasn't played that well, has he?
Ridgie six.
We always talk on this show about the importance of a good centre-back, a good good organisation within your team that comes from your back, and he's been missing, and that's, he had a great partnership last year with Boris, and it just hasn't been there this year. But you know, there are other problems, not problems, there's just been other things that have not quite clicked this season, and plus, you know, they've come off the back of winning MLS, and it's always tough to sort of get that going again. So yeah, they've struggled a little bit this season, but you know, they've gone up a notch in the last couple of years, and I think there's a lot more expected of them now. So this would actually be seen as quite a good season for them, but because they've hit the heights last season, then it's a bit topsy-turvy.
Definitely. I mean, that has been such a big thing with Liam Ridswell being out. He's missed a big chunk of games, out again at the moment.
Yeah.
Just on, he's out injured, and MLS chose to suspend him for this game. Even though he was out injured, which is a bit of a mad one.
Yeah.
Anyway, that's done and dusted. Lost, I mean, a big loss to them. Nat Borchers doing his Achilles in. Oof. Out for the season.
Achilles, that's an awful,
it's a bad
awful
injury, isn't
injury
it?
Yeah.
But he tweeted the other day that he's on the road to recovery already.
Plenty of time to keep that beard growing. You'll come back here.
He's got a bit of a Nat Borchers look.
No, Nat Borchers has got a bit of a ped look. Let's get it right. When he comes down, he'll be like proper ZZ Top, won't he, when he comes back? But there's talk that they're going to bring in Stephen Taylor.
Yeah.
Or they might, you know what, by the time this video goes out, they might have already brought in Stephen Taylor, who, good player, good dependable player, was very, very, was a very, very good young centre-back and lost his way a little bit, probably because of the club he was playing for, weren't known for nurturing defenders, let's just say. Maybe if someone else had got the hands on him when he was a bit younger and coached him a little bit better.
Rafa would have had him younger.
But he is a very good player, and I think if he comes to MLS and he settles in and takes it the bull by the horns like Liam Ridgewell has, then I think he could be a very, very good signing. And a signing that I think a lot of other MLS teams should be making. And we've said this for a very long time.
Definitely, I think he can do a fantastic job for them going, especially with Borchers being out. If he can get Ridgewell fit again and have him and Taylor at centre-half. Taylor can also play right full-back as well. I think he'll do really, really well there. I mean, just looking at them, I mean, for any UK fans watching Portland Timbers, what a club. Tifos, king of the Tifo.
A lot of English people mightn't even know what a Tifo is, though, so might need
explain
to
explain it.
Well, basically, you know, They get together before the game, days before the game, and they organise a massive spectacle at the beginning of the game, usually involving lots of paint, lots of smoke, a huge banner.
Yeah.
You know, anyone who's watched European games, a huge banner that covers all the fans and gets all the fans involved in a way. You know, we've seen like the Dorothy to Oz one, we've seen the Freddy Krueger one. We've seen the little trees with get all the fans involved, and it's just amazing to see the time and the effort that goes in, the choreography that goes into it, and just fans getting together and doing something together I think that's what a bonding experience that must be for fans, not just turning up on the day of a game to be doing things all week long. It's a special club.
They're like a real, I mean, go and check out the Timbers Army done a season preview video for us, and it was absolutely fantastic, and it was all bits and pieces about
it's what amazing.
It's incredible, actually, to be fair, but it is a real football soccer club, yeah. Isn't it? The fans are
that
incredible.
That Pacific Northwest has just got. It's got some. I don't know. They'll have to tell me why it seems to be different from the rest of America. Well, I know America's got a lot of different parts of it, but that Pacific Northwest, it's got a real football culture.
Yeah, like a European.
But I don't know where it comes from because. No. I don't know. Do people have to tell me? Maybe because. It's like all the trees and all the greenery and all the grass the rain, and maybe it's got a European climate to it, or maybe I just don't know. The whole area has got
unique.
Yeah, the whole area's got something about it, because obviously Seattle and you've got Vancouver, and it's brilliant. And you know what? They've done a lot of things. I remember when they done. I think it was a young lad had cancer, I think, and they organised this game on like a Tuesday afternoon, and they filled the home end, like the fans turned up en masse, and the teams came out like a proper MLS match day, and they made it just for this kid, like a Make-A-Wish thing, and it was absolutely amazing. But what was amazing was that not only was where the club did it all and it made it look like a spectacle, but the fans turned out and they treated it like a match day, and they had all the banners and all the smoke, and they were chanting this kid's name and little things like, it was like a Tuesday afternoon or something. It was amazing, and little things like that, you know. I've loved Portland for since their inception, and they're a club like, I mean, I'm a Sporting Kansas fan, but Portland, there's just something about them that I find, it's almost like, if I'm at home, I've got my Everton team, and I might have a little European team I look out for. They're like my European team in MLS. I've got Sporting, but then I've got
soft spot for.
Yeah, definitely. And listen, I'm rambling on, but it's such a unique club, and the ground's great. I love the ground, the way it's so small and compact, and I can't wait to visit.
21,144 into Providence Park. I've seen a stat. I don't know if this is true. Well, it will be, but. Sold out 65 consecutive games on the run, home games on the run. There's 10,000 on the waiting list and stuff like that. So
I tell you what, it's a good job I'm being nice, because if I want a ticket, I'm gonna have to rely on someone aren't I really heavily to get me a ticket. So
they have also Timber Joey.
Yeah,
as a goal goes in, the old
chainsaw cut the wood, give the wood to the player.
The wood up and all amazing, it's absolutely
so unique.
Fantastic club. Let's move on to the football side of it before we wrap it up. This season, played 23 games, won 7, drawn 8, lost 8, scored 33, conceded 34, got 29 points. Lost this week to the shirt you're wearing.
Sporting
Kansas City, who have been on a resurgence at the moment. They're starting to pick it
at home. At home, they're great at home. It's been a difficult month, July. They've lost the last couple of games. They lost to LA Galaxy, which they really shouldn't have lost. They did beat Seattle, which would be a big one for them. They won't really care about the rest of the month. But they're still in there. I think one player who needs to find a little bit more form is Darlington Nagbe.
Yeah.
If he can find a little bit of form, he could be the catalyst to go. Because I don't... To be fair, I mean... Top of my head, I don't think they're in anywhere different than they were this time last year.
No, they've
they just kicked on.
Yeah.
And kicked on, and they had
probably about now.
Yeah. And obviously, you know, had a little bit of luck in the playoffs with the penalty shootout.
Most ridiculous penalty
shootout. You know, with posts and all that. And who knows?
They're in seventh at the moment. The home record, 7 wins, 3 draws, 2 defeats. Sorry, 3 defeats, 2 draws away from home. No wins, 5 defeats and 6 draws. So obviously, if they can pick a couple of road wins up, that'll make a big difference. They're in 7th at the moment.
Yeah, Vancouver. They're a point off Vancouver. There's a bit of a gap between them and Real Salt Lake and Sporting Kansas City and LA Galaxy. So yeah, they have to put a few games. They have to turn that corner now. August has got to be the month that they turn the corner. over the MLS all-star hump, and they've got to start kicking in. New signing like Stephen Taylor, get Ridgie back in there, form a solid partnership, and that could be the catalyst to see them into the playoffs.
Definitely. I mean, Fernando Addy again, 10 goals, 2 assists. Diego Valeri has been fantastic this season. He's got 9 goals and 5 assists. And then there's Jack McInerney. They need a few more goals. Yeah. Someone to help out Addy. And it could well be Nagby, because he's got the ability, Nagby, but not enough goals.
No consistency this year. You know, after such a good season last year, there's been no consistency. If you can find a little bit of consistency in his game, he could be the little spark, and obviously if they get the defensive.
Milano as well, who's got all the skill, beats players with fun, and couldn't score in a brothel. I've said it. But, Portland Timbers, definitely a unique club. Can't go without saying Jake Gleeson, who's come in this season in goal instead of Kwasi, has been fantastic as well. What a club they are. Meta Paulson, big with the fans as well, developed. Such a special club. Have a look out for them if you're a UK watcher, Portland Timbers. Portland Timbers fans, let us know in the comment section below what you think. Can you do it again? Can you, over the hump, can you go and retain MLS Cup? What's been the difference between last year? Or hasn't there been any difference? Because I know that, as Ped said before, it's exactly the same, almost snuck in at the end and got on that run. So can he do it back to back? Who knows? Let us know in the comment section below. Don't forget to look out for more videos from me and Ped, and we'll catch you soon.